Hey guys, one of the easiest ways to assess your fitness level is by measuring your resting heart rate. This is the number of times your heart has to beat in 60 seconds at complete rest. While there are now wearables that track your resting heart rate, the most reliable method involves counting it yourself. The best time to do this is first thing upon waking up, even before you've got out of bed. So when you wake up, either stay lying down or maybe sit up slightly and prop yourself up with a pillow. Take a few minutes to settle again, then you'll need a timer and to locate your pulse. The two places people tend to find easiest for their pulse are the neck or the side of the wrist below the thumb. Unless you're impossibly busy, you can hopefully afford to count for a full minute, which is slightly more accurate than counting for 15 seconds and multiplying by 4. So with your pulse located, start the timer, then immediately start counting. Keep counting until the timer reaches 60 seconds, at which point stop on the number you're on, and that is your resting heart rate. For people without any health conditions, your resting heart rate should reflect your overall fitness and heart health. However, certain factors can influence the result. Heart disease, thyroid conditions, infections, and inflammatory diseases like lupus may cause your heart to beat faster or slower than if you were in good health. There are also more acute causes like a very intense workout the previous day or a fever that would see it higher than your usual baseline. If you don't think any of those apply to you, then it should be a reasonable reflection of your health and fitness level. That is because a stronger heart can pump more blood per heartbeat, so it doesn't have to work as hard at rest. Using my wearable data, here's my resting heart rate across a recent week of training. I have 2 sprint sessions followed by weights on Tuesdays and Thursdays, and as expected, I see a clear jump in resting heart rate the following mornings. In this case, I'm better off waiting until my lower intensity days and then measuring the following morning in order to get a more reliable number. While the overall trend gives the impression the data is reliable, I took a week of manual readings and those came out consistently higher than my Whoop strap. In fact, my other wearable tells me it's even lower than my Whoop, sometimes under 40 beats per minute. Moving to a longer term picture, it becomes very obvious when I've had bouts of illness, and it's not unusual to see resting heart rate rise by 15 or 20 beats per minute while your body is fighting an infection. Here are the normative values for men between the ages of 20 and 70. You can see there isn't really that big an effect with age, so 55 beats per minute or below would classify you as an athlete, while 80, 82 and above is poor. Women tend to have smaller hearts, so the graph shifts up slightly with athletes now being 60 or lower, and poor from 85 beats per minute and up. In terms of tracking over time, as you can see, it shouldn't really change much year to year, assuming you're doing the same amount of activity. While it might be nice to measure every 3 months just to see how you're getting on, a more valuable time to measure might be after a significant change in the amount of exercise that you're doing. Measuring before and after is a great way to see what effect the training has had on your fitness level. As I said, the fitter you are, the stronger your heart, and the lower your resting heart rate should be. Thanks for watching.